Hi everyone, good evening, this is Melissa here. Got a little new wig on, just trying out Super Blonde and Long. I have just gone through another week living as myself and feeling very happy. I have had still the most amazing support. It's been really interesting because I guess as an overthinker, I tend to maybe think about things too much in that I make up I guess scenarios and judgments, which you know we all judge, without actually having any facts about things. So you know, I was so worried about generations, and I really don't think we give the older generation enough credit for their acceptance of transgender people and just life in general. Somebody said something really interesting to me, and you know, being a parent, you know, makes a big difference to acceptance as well, and not wanting their child to be unhappy. In my salon, I have been cutting people's hair, and my other stylists at work there, their clients have come up to me and just rested their hand on my shoulder and said how lovely my makeup's looking, which, you know, it's a small comment, but it is an acceptance, and it's been a real eye-opener for the older generation that I was worried about that wasn't going to understand it. But I'm also not putting myself in positions into where I'm around, you know, drunk people who might want to say things that are on their mind, but also insincere. So I'm in places where people are talking honestly about how they feel and not on a drunk and in front of their friends and thinking it's funny to say comments. So I think it's really important in the process. You know, I am going to go out and I will start putting myself in those sort of positions as well. But for the moment, I've found that, you know, I guess slowly does it, and feeling comfortable and making sure that you know that people are happy for your happiness is the most important thing. I have been spending my week just working really, but also I'm sort of gone on a different journey while I'm sort of campaigning. I live in Chichester, and it's a very small city. It has got a college, a university, it's got a great theatre, but there is no presence of the LGBT community at all. So I'm working very closely with a good friend of mine, Dawn Gracie, and I'm setting up on the 26th of January 2019 a place where we can meet up all genders, no labels, no boxes, you know, all allies are welcome also. We're just organising setting up a poster to promote it. But if anyone is nearby and wants to come, it's going to be at the Vestry on South Street on the 26th, Monday the 26th of January. It's just a meetup just to see what people want from their city and what people are missing out on. I would really love to help in a way if there's any other trans people that want to go out dressed for the first time but are scared, and a space where people can talk. I want to try and involve everybody in just being a part of everyone's journey and any kind of support that's there. I was on Stonewall on their website, and there is nothing on there. When you scroll down or type in Chichester in the postcode, it says no results found. So I'm looking to change that, and I'm looking to integrate Chichester more, especially being a university city and have a great theatre. You know, there's people coming to the city from all over the UK and possibly even the world. So it's important, I think, that there is more in Chichester for all genders and however you identify yourself. I went to an amazing night. Dawn Gracie holds these Chichester Cabaret Clubs every other month, and it was a drag king and drag queen special. Now, I still love, you know, I'm still a showgirl, I still love the dressing up, and, you know, I had butterflies in my hair, and I still love that side of things, and I think it's amazing, because it's the only place in Chichester at the moment where people who feel that they can't necessarily go into sort of your mainstream pubs for fear of, you know, still, you know, just people being drunk and maybe feeling a bit belittled. So it was there, it was amazing, the acts were fantastic, and you know, great support all over in the people that attended and people on stage, just inspirational, and also just fun as well. So, yeah, I've just been feeling a lot more clarity. Somebody said, Dawn said to me today, I back when I was Mark, I was like a little lost lamb, like a deer in headlights. I didn't know what I needed, what I wanted. I was trying to escape, and I sort of mentioned about, going to Narcotics Anonymous. It was a really, really interesting session that I went to this week, and I didn't want to bring in Mark into Melissa. I really didn't want to taint myself with that drug addiction. So I when I was talking, I referred to myself as Mark still. And there was this guy called Mark, actually, and he said at the end, he pulled me up at the end and he said, what's your name? And I said, Mel. And he said, well, you look like Mel. And asked, why did I not want to, speak as myself? And he said, it's really important to, if you want to lose that drug addict, to come as Melissa every time and not to bring Mark with me. And I thought that was really lovely and hadn't looked at it in that way. So it was very important that I went, actually, because I was feeling almost like I don't need to go anymore. I'm cured almost. But actually it was a real good wake up, not a wake up call, but it was good to open my eyes to see that actually, if things do start going wrong, it's not other people or being around other people that do it. It's actually me. And if I get into, so Melissa as myself, I can still, if I get into a state where I'm upset, I still know where to go to maybe think that I can sort myself out. So I need to still keep going. So that's been a really, really good part of this week, to sort of leave Mark behind and keep Melissa moving forward. Also this week, so now that I'm, ever so confident and comfortable going out, it's things like, as you can see now, it's about 5:15 p.m. My tash is coming back and my beard. So sometimes I'm shaving twice a day, which is not obviously great for my skin. Things like clothes I want to wear. So if there's anyone out there that's watching that has gone through like tucking, now you might, this is a bit personal. I have an inflamed testes, so I can't tuck. I can't push my balls up to where my ovaries would be. So I'm really looking for any like control pants. I know you can get those ones that suck your belly in, but it's more the penis area that I need to learn how to wear my willy, basically. So if there's anyone out there that can give me any information on that, I'd be very grateful. So that's my week. It's been really good. And I'm now, the next week, just focusing on trying to start promoting this social meetup for the LGBT community of Chichester. If, like I said, if anyone is free and wants to come, and we want to just bring people out and just make their presence in Chichester to know that, we are around. We don't need to go to Portsmouth or Brighton. That we want to make somewhere that is a safe space, but also integrated with society. I'm not trying to create a place where, we're in one corner. We are going to be in the vestry in South Street, and I think it's important to be visible. So if anyone, allies as much as the LGBT community are very, very welcome. It will be it's free tickets, but there will be an event coming up on Eventbrite very shortly. But I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to go maybe to touch up my makeup a little bit. But thank you for listening again, and I shall speak to you all next week.